Okay.
Okay.
That's good.
That's good.
Okay, Hannah, what are you doing? Okay. Hannah, do you remember the story about Ibrahim and Hassan? Do you remember?
Yes, I do.
Okay, very good. And do you remember the word that we learned together?
Yes.
Okay, now there are some words here like cold, slowly, whispered, stupid, and kind. Do you know the opposites of these words?
Kind is unkind. Stupid is stupid and smart.
Wow.
Whisper and say loudly.
Wow, shout. For example, shout. Shouting, of course.
Slowly. And pass the cold and hot.
Oh, that's great. Very good. Well, now we're going to read and listen to another track, to another audio, okay, and read another story together. So let's learn, let's read, and let's listen together, okay?
Okay.
Well, actually, a story that's happened in Mexico. So let's listen. Just give me a moment. Okay. Okay, it's 27.
Track 27.
Rattlesnake and Mouse. It was evening in the desert. Mouse ran here and there looking for seeds to eat. As Mouse ran past a rock, he heard a voice.
Help, help, said the voice. I am trapped under this rock.
Is that you, Rattlesnake? Asked Mouse.
Yes, it's me, said Rattlesnake. Please push the rock and let me out.
If I let you out, you will eat me, said Mouse.
No, I won't eat you, I promise, said Rattlesnake. Please, let me out.
Okay, said Mouse. Mouse pushed and pushed until the big rock rolled over. Out came Rattlesnake.
Thank you, Mouse, said Rattlesnake. I was under that rock for a long time, and I am very hungry. A little mouse is just what I need for dinner.
Wait, said Mouse. You can't eat me. I've just saved your life.
You are a kind and fair animal, Mouse, smiled Rattlesnake, but I am not. I am a hungry rattlesnake, and I am going to eat you.
Just then, Coyote trotted by. Mouse called out, Coyote, please talk to Rattlesnake. Rattlesnake was trapped under this big rock. I rolled the rock over and saved her life. Now she's going to eat me. That's so unfair. Coyote stopped to listen.
What did you say, Mouse? Were you trapped under this big rock?
No, said Mouse. Rattlesnake was trapped under that rock.
I'm sorry, I don't understand, said Coyote. Did Rattlesnake push this big rock over?
No, shouted Mouse. I pushed that rock over.
Oh, I'm so confused, said Coyote. Explain it again, please. Did Rattlesnake save your life?
This is ridiculous, said Rattlesnake. How can you be so stupid, Coyote? I'll show you what happened.
Rattlesnake slithered back into the hole by the rock.
I was here, and that big rock was on top of me, Rattlesnake explained.
Like this?
Asked Coyote as he rolled the rock back on top of Rattlesnake.
Yes, said Rattlesnake. Now do you understand?
Do you understand?
Yes, said Coyote. Yes. Now I understand. Good, said Rattlesnake. Now push the rock over and let me out.
Oh, no, said Coyote. I don't want to let you out. I think it is good that you are under that rock.
Thank you, Coyote. You've saved my life, laughed Mouse. I thought you were being stupid, but you were just pretending.
That's right, said Coyote. I'm a very clever animal. I'm the cleverest animal in the desert. Now, stay safe, Mouse, and don't help any more rattlesnakes.
Oh, wow. Such a good story. Okay, let me ask you something. Hannah, do you think the story is fiction or non-fiction? Let me explain what is fiction and what is non-fiction. Fiction means imaginary. It's not real. Imaginary and based on imagination of writer. So it means something imaginary, not real, not real story. But non-fiction based on fact. Factual information, so it can be real. Okay, now tell me, is this story fiction or non-fiction?
It's non-fiction.
Wow, so is it real, you think?
No, because the animal cannot talk.
So, of course, very good. So, this is fiction. Fiction. Okay, fiction means imaginary, but non-fiction means real story. Okay, let me put them here. And this is real. This is
imaginary.
Okay, so the story is fiction, of course, because the animals can't talk. Very good. Well, we have some Yeah? What do you say?
I very, very like the story.
Yeah, you like the story very much?
Yes.
So do I. I like it very much. So let's read it again. Of course, we're going to read it again. The story take place, happen. Happen means take place in Mexico.
In the Sonoran Desert.
Very good. And Coyote is
a character in many tales from Mexico.
He's always
clever. He often tricks other animals. Read to find out how Coyote tricks Rattlesnake in this story.
Okay, and Rattlesnake. Okay, actually, Rattlesnake is a kind of a snake, as you can see, that can make noise using, actually, when moving its tail. So when it's angry, it moves its tail and make noise. This means rattlesnake, okay?
Okay.
For example, ding, 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 something like this, something like this, make a noise, okay? Well, now let's read the story again. Okay, it was evening. Would you read it, please, again?
It was evening in the desert. Mouse ran here and there looking for a seed to eat. As Mouse ran past a rock, he heard a voice. Help! Help! Said the voice. I am trapped under this rock. Is that you, Rattlesnake? Asked Mouse. Yes, it's me, said Rattlesnake. Please push the rock and let me out. If I let you out, you will eat me, said Mouse. No, I won't eat you, I promise, said Rattlesnake. Please let me out. Okay, said Mouse. Mouse pushed it and pushed until the big rock rolled over. Out came Rattlesnake.
Oh, so what happened? Okay. Mouse ran here and they're looking for seed to eat, some food seed, okay, to eat. And suddenly someone said,
yeah.
Help, I'm trapped. Trap. Do you know the meaning of trap?
It means we cannot get out of there.
Of course, very good. You're in an unpleasant situation and you can't move and actually you lack freedom. Okay, so, and it was Rattlesnake. Rattlesnake asked for help, but Mouse said,
no.
Mm-hmm. Of course, it said no, because
if I let you out, you will eat me.
Very good. But finally, Mouse pushed and pushed until the big rock rolled over, and out came
Rattlesnake.
Oh, dangerous. Now let's read the rest of the story.
Thank you, Mouse, said Rattlesnake. I was under that rock for a long time, and I am very hungry. A little mouse is just what I need for dinner. Wait, said Mouse. You can eat me. I just saved your life. You are a kind and fair animal, Mouse. My rattlesnake, but I am not. I am a hungry rattlesnake, and I am going to eat you. Just then, Coyote trot by. Mouse called out. Coyote, please talk to rattlesnake. Rattlesnake was trapped under this big rock. I rolled the rock over and saved her life. Now she is going to eat me. That's so unfair.
Of course, it's not fair. Of course, just then Coyote ran. And Mouse called out, Coyote, please talk to Rattlesnake. It want to eat me. And, okay, keep going. Coyote stopped
to listen. What did you say, Mouse? Were you trapped under this big rock? No, said Mouse. Rattlesnake was trapped under that rock. I'm sorry, I don't understand, said Coyote. Did Rattlesnake push this big rock over? No, shouted Mouse. I pushed that rock over. Oh, I'm so confused.
I'm so confused. I can't understand, said Coyote.
Explain it again, please. Did Rattlesnake save your life? This is ridiculous, said Rattlesnake. How can you be so stupid? Coyote, I'll show you what happened.
Okay.
Rattlesnake slipped back into the hole by the rock. I was here, and that big rock was on top of me. Rattlesnake explained like this. As Coyote, as he rolled the rock back on top of Rattlesnake. Yes, said Rattlesnake. Now do you understand? Yes, said Coyote. Now I understand. Good, said Rattlesnake. Now push the rock over and let me out.
Okay, okay, wait a minute, please, hold on. Rattlesnake slithered. Slither, what does it mean? Slither, do you know the meaning of slither?
It means like this.
Like this, of course, slithered back into the hole by the rock and tried to explain, tried to say, to tell the story and that what happened. Sad Coyote.
Coyote, I don't want to let you out. I think it is good that you are under that rock. Thank you, Coyote. You saved my life. Left mouse. I thought you were being stupid, but you were just pretending. That's right, said Coyote. I'm a very clever animal. I'm the cleverest animal in the desert. Now stay safe, mouse, and don't help any more rattlesnake.
Wow, so mouse said, I thought you were being stupid, but you were just pretending. What does it mean when I pretend? It means I want to show something, but it's not real. For example, I want to show that I'm angry, but I'm not angry. I'm pretending. Okay, for example, I want to show you that I'm really clever, but actually I'm not clever. Making you, okay? This is pretending. Get it?
Okay.
Okay, very good. Now, Hannah, can you pretend that you are very happy? Yeah, of course. That's it. Very good. Okay, now, let's answer the questions according to the story that we read together. Where was Rattlesnake at the beginning of the story?
It's under that rock.
Of course. And where was Rattlesnake at the end of the story?
Still under that rock.
Of course. How did Mouse help Rattlesnake?
The little mouse rolled. The raw into it, roll out, and let Rattlesnake get up.
So, small mouse pushed and pushed. Remember, pushed and pushed until the big rock rolled over. So, pushed until the big rock rolled over. Okay, now. Yes, dear.
I like the coyote and the mouse.
Of course. I like the coyote as well.
And I see the rattlesnake is very stupid.
Yeah, of course. And actually, I have seen an animation about a real smart fox. And, you know, of course, it was a coyote, it was fox, but it was really, really clever. And Zootopia.
I like the rattlesnake and the mouse and the coyote.
Okay, very good. So tell me, have you seen Zootopia?
What is Zootopia?
It's an animation.
Yes.
Oh, can you tell me the story?
Is the mouse
Zootopia?
What is the story?
Okay, so can you tell me what the movie is about?
No, it's the story.
Okay, so tell me if you watched it, tell me.
Smart Mr. Fox.
Wow, very good. It was about... So I'm going to do something for you, okay? I think it's not bad to watch this movie and next session talk about it, okay? Do you like to?
Oh, and I very, very like this video. Is this? What time is for you?
Oh, you're talking? Queen Gambit. Okay. Gambit. So it's interesting. I like it. But this one, Hannah, is amazing. It's very, 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 very beautiful and amazing and exciting animation. So I will send it to you, okay? Okay.
Zootopia.
Zootopia, of course. And tell me, what did Rattlesnake want to do to Mouse? What did Rattlesnake want to do to Mouse?
What did you say? If I say, I hear you say it's like, it's not clear.
Yeah, question number four. What did Rattlesnake want to do to Mouse?
Rattlesnake want to eat the little mouse.
Very good. And why did Mouse say that's so unfair?
Because the mouse say the rattlesnake and the little mouse hear that the rattlesnake said, I won't eat you, I promise. So the little mouse push and push the rock, so the little mouse let the rattlesnake out, but the rattlesnake want to eat the mouse, so the mouse said that's so unfair.
Of course, great. And how did Coyote trick Rattlesnake?
Is Coyote pretend that Coyote is the stupid animal, and the coyote tricked the rattlesnake go into that hole again, and the rattlesnake said the coyote pushed the rock, and so the coyote pushed the rock and the rattlesnake was under that hole. So So the rattlesnake said, now let me out. And Coyote said, I'll not let you out.
Wow, very good. You could tell the story very well. Excellent. Okay, now, would you read these questions and answer them using yes and no? The first one.
Was rattlesnake kind? No, she wasn't.
Okay.
Was mouse helpful? Yes, he was. Did rattlesnake eat mouse? No, she didn't. Did coyote save mouse's life? Yes, he did.
Wow, very good. Okay. Now, let's talk about something. Hannah, in the story, coyote tricked rattlesnake. Do you think this was fair or unfair?
It's fair.
It's fair. Why? Why do you think it's fair?
Because the rattlesnake wants to eat the mouse. But at the first time, the rattlesnake said, I won't eat you.
Very good. And do you think Coyote should go back and let Rattlesnake out?
I think no.
Of course no. Of course no. And have you ever seen an animal or a person?
Yes.
Oh, what did you do?
I tricked that in the quiz. I have four friends. Three friends go with me to the ICT room, and they do a quiz with me. The teacher said, and my friend asked, 100 minus 63 equal what? And so that was in grade two. And then I said equal 46. So I tricked my friend, and I asked myself, do my friend think is correct? So my friend clicked on that answer and it's not correct.
That was really clever. Okay, so you could trick your friend. Okay, was it fair or unfair?
It's fair because my friend always look at my question, and when I was wrong, they don't do like me. They do correctly.
Oh, of course. So your friend needs to study more. And of course, I do agree with you. It's not good to cheat. Cheating is not good. So it was fair. And has anyone ever tricked you?
I didn't remember.
Okay, very good. Well, now, look at these blue words from the story and match the sentences with the same meaning. Okay, so it was evening.
Is Rattlesnake want to eat? She needs some food?
No, so when you say it was evening, it means...
It was the end of the day.
Very good. Number two, Rattlesnake is trapped.
It means Rattlesnake can get out.
Very good. And number three?
If Rattlesnake wants to eat, she needs some food.
Wow, very good. I'm confused.
What is confused? I don't remember.
It means I don't understand. It is something that I don't understand.
If I don't understand.
Very good. Excellent. Explain what happened. Explain.
Tell me what happened.
Very good. Tell me what happened. So, evening, trapped, hungry, confused, and explain. Okay?
Okay.
Well, good. Now, let's do something else. Okay, well. I want to show you something. Let me show you. Wait a moment. I want to show you something. Then, if you like it, I'm going to send it to you. Just give me a moment. Wait. Okay, I want to show you something, so let me... Let's watch. Let's watch it together.
Oh, I know. I have that song.
You have? You have the song? Okay, so tell me, have you seen this animation?
I didn't watch it.
This is Utopia.
I messed up tonight. I lost another fight. I still mess up, but I'll just start again. I keep on down. I keep on hitting the ground. But I always get enough to see what's next. Birds don't just fly, they fall down.
The song of Zootopia, and I really like it. This is amazing animated film. I really like it. Okay, now let me share the book again. Okay, so do you like to watch this animated film? Do you want?
Yes, I want.
Okay, so let's do something. I'm going to do something. So I will send you, the link of this movie. And you can see at home, next session, you will talk about it, okay? And tell me, for example, what happened in the story. Okay, good.
Okay.
Well, great. Now let's keep going with our book again. Okay. Now, tell me, Hannah, who was your favorite character in this story?
Which one?
Coyote or mouse or snake?
Oh, wow,
great, very good. Okay, so you like all of them. And tell me why do you like all of them? Why?
Because Coyote is a smart animal.
Coyote is smart, and Mouse is?
And Mouse is helpful and a kind animal.
And how about this snake?
He's stupid, but it can trick the mouse
Of course, tricky and
trick the mouse to let me out.
But tricky and stupid. Tricky and stupid. Okay, very good. Well, okay, now. So, choose a project. We're going to do project. Okay. Choose a desert. What continent is your desert on? Do some research. Is your desert sandy or rocky? All the mountains or actually canyons? And what plants and animals live in your desert? So you need to do something, Hannah. Okay. You need to draw a picture to me. You need to draw a picture of your desert. Okay. And of course, you need to draw plants and animals. And you need to write some facts about the plants and animals in desert. Okay. So you need to talk about and explain your desert. Okay.
Okay.
This is your homework.
I love drawing.
Ah, okay. Hannah, how is the weather?
It's a little bit rainy.
Oh, a little bit rainy. Okay, do you like rainy days? Okay, so rainy, snowy, or sunny?
I like warm.
Oh, you like?
Warm.
Warm. Okay, so sunny days. Sunny days.
Sometimes I like rainy because it's cold, so I can sleep.
Oh, I got it. So you can sleep more. Wow, of course. So you like sometimes really cloudy, sometimes sunny, but you don't like rainy.
Yes, I like.
Okay, so tell me, do you like snowy days?
Yes, I really love snowy.
Okay.
So I can play snowball and so I can build a snowman.
Of course, you can make snowman with a carrot nose. And you know, we don't say, okay? We say, I like very much. I like it very much, okay?
Very much.
Of course, I like it very much. Very good. Well, now, let's examine. Okay, let's check if you learned everything or no. So, I'm going to ask you some questions and you need to remember something that you learned in the lesson and answer the questions, okay?
Okay.
Ready?
I'm ready.
Let's get started. What is the weather like in a desert?
It's hot. It's very, 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 very hot.
And how are days and nights different?
At the day, it's very hot, but in the night time, it's very cold.
Okay, very good. And look at the fact cards about the Jerboa and the Fennec folks on page 37. Of course, we know Fennec folks and Jerboa. And talk with your partner about ways that these two desert animals are the same. How are they the same?
It has ears.
Of course. Yeah, they have ears and
they have long tail.
Of course. And they live in desert. Yeah. And when it's too hot,
they dig a hole and they go into the hole.
Very good. Excellent. Okay, very good. And now, tell me, Hannah, the most interesting thing that you learned in this lessons unit.
We have to be smart.
Wow, of course.
We had to be kind.
Very good.
Very good.
And we also had to treat someone else if we in trouble. Just like if we in the hole, we had to treat someone so we can get out. It's good for us.
Wow, excellent. Very good. Of course, we need to be helpful. We need to help people and others. Okay, and now look at this pictures, okay, and tell me if you remember the stories, this one?
Yes, Abraham and Hansel.
Very good. And do you know the name of this plant? It begins with C.
C.
Begins in C.
Begins in
C. C-A.
C-A.
C.
C.
Cac.
Cactus.
Cactus. Cactus. Cactus, of course, cactus. Okay, well, now you can talk about desert weather, you can talk and write about desert plants and animals, and you can compare things that are like and different. You can ask and answer questions about things that happened. Okay, you can read and talk about, and of course, act out story. Wow, lots of things to learn. Okay, that's really good. Well, now, okay. Well, so, look at these pictures, okay? The pictures on this page are trick our eyes. They are called optical illusions. Follow the instructions, then talk about what you find out. Okay, so. Which line is longer, A or B?
B.
B is longer. Wow.
B is longer.
Yeah. And
A is shorter.
Yeah, look at the yellow circle in the middle of each flower. Which yellow circle is bigger, A or B?
B is bigger. And A is smaller.
They are the same, I think. You know, they're tricky. You know, these pictures actually trick our eyes. So because, let me show you something. Because
I think maybe the yellow thing is equal, same. It's equal.
Of course, yellows are equal, because of the circles, you know, surrounding circles, that, for example, these circles are smaller and these ones are bigger, we think that, okay, this one is bigger, okay, but actually they're the same. Well, let's look at this one and look at the blue line and the orange line on the wall. Which line is longer?
Is orange,
okay, but I think it's another trick. I think this should be, I don't know, maybe the same, yeah.
It's the same.
You know,
because
why
that one is not away.
Of course, and of as you can course. See, this cube, you know, is larger than this one. So as you can see, actually, at this point, the wall is taller and larger. And then step by step, actually, the size of this, you know, something like squares change to smaller. So I think they're the same. Do you agree?
Okay.
Well, do you know the name of these shapes? This is
square.
This is
circle.
This is
triangle.
This is
rectangle.
This is
cube.
Very good. Okay, so which one is your favorite one?
And I know the line of symmetry.
Oh, you know lots of things. Okay, well, so which one do you like best? A square, circle, triangle, rectangle, or cube? Which one do you normally use when you're drawing?
A circle.
Circle, I like it too. Okay, well, now look at the pictures and read the questions, then say what you find out. So, what shape can you see in this picture? What shape?
This circle and cube.
Wow, very good. So, let me draw it.
And square.
Of course, a cube consists of some squares. Okay, and this one, okay, look at the title, the little white circle. Okay, my eyes can't see anymore. It's so, what is this? Okay, look at the little white circle. Can you see black dots too? Oh, they're changing. Wow, can you see they're changing? I can't count them. Can you see?
Wait.
Oh, can you count them? I can't.
I can't.
My eyes can't see anything. And do you think, Hannah, can you see black dots? Can you see?
Yes.
Yes, and do you think they're real?
No.
I know, of course. I got confused. Okay. I think, and we call them optical illusion. So.
So it's
really tricky. Do you agree? It's really tricky. Of course. Yeah. That's really interesting. You know, it's something like it seems different, but actually it's something different. It's really interesting, you know? And we don't know if something that we are, you know, we see exists or no. Is it real or no?
It says
illusion.
Illusion.
So optical illusion is an experience of seeing, you know, it's something like seeming to see something which doesn't exist, is other than it appears. So it means different from it appears. So when actually something like it seems that something exists, but actually it doesn't, we say optical illusion. Wow, that's interesting. Okay, so we need to do this. Of course, next session. Oh, We have lots of things to do for next session. This one is interesting, so we will do it. So we can make it next session. Okay, my dear. So that's enough for now. Do you have any questions, any issues about this word?
Why do we can see the black dots?
Why? Because this is optical illusion. Actually, it's a trick. You know, they make something in some way that you think there are some black dots, but it's different. Actually, these dots don't exist, okay? There is no black dots, but we think, okay, this is something. Actually, this type of shapes trick our mind, trick our brain, okay? So that we think that something exists, but it doesn't. Get it?
Okay,
my dear, time is over and we need to go. So don't forget to do something that I asked you. And next session, I will see you.